More than 2,600 species of snakes all over the world, including the marine forms, and, out of which only 300 species are poisonous. In India, there are 330 species only, and among them only 69 species are poisonous. As per record of the WHO, nearly 30,000 to 40,000 persons die of snake bite in the world every year. Today we are learn about biting mechanism of snake. Without any further delay, let's start.
The biting apparatus taking part in the biting process are poison glands, poison ducts, and poison teeth or fangs. Now we are discuss in detail. Poison gland. There is one pair of poison glands, each one is situated on either side of the upper jaw. The poison glands are actually the parotid glands. Each poison gland is sac-like in appearance. They are held in position by some ligaments. With the help of anterior ligament, the gland is attached with the maxilla. The posterior ligament is present between the gland and the quadrant. In addition to these, fan-shaped ligaments are also situated between the side walls and squamoso-quadrate junction. Poison duct. Each poison gland is provided with a narrow duct at its anterior portion, which passes along the side of the upper jaw, loops over itself, and finally opens at the base of the fang. Poison teeth or fangs. There's one pair of fangs in the upper jaw. They are enlarged maxillary teeth which are very sharp and pointed. There is great power of regeneration.
On the basis of structure and position, the fangs are of the following types. Protroglyphs type. The fangs are comparatively small and they are present in front of the maxillae. The fang has a groove all along its anterior face. Examples: cobra, krait, sea snakes and coral snakes. Stenoglyphs type. The fangs are movable and turned inside. Poison canal runs through the fang and opens at the tip. Examples: vipers and rattlesnakes. Opisthoglyphs type. The fangs are small and lie at the back portion of maxillae. The fang has a groove along its posterior face. Examples: some colubrid snake, African tree snakes. Agalyphs type. Agalyphs dentition is present in the non-poisonous snakes. Process of biting. When the digastric muscle contracts, the mandible is lowered and the skull along with the upper jaws goes up. As a result, the mouth opens. The distal end of the quadrant is pushed forward, which thrusts the pterygoid, palatine and transverse bar. Contraction of the sphenopterygoid muscle also contributes to the above process, and pterygoid is pulled forward and ectopterygoid is pushed upward. The upward movement of ectopterygoid brings about a rotation of maxilla on its own axis, and as a result fangs are erected. The mouth closes by the contraction of anterior temporalis and pterygoid muscles. Fangs pierce into the skin of the victim. Vi, muscles associated with the poison gland, masseter and mandibular, contract, and the poison is squeezed into the body of the victim through the poison ducts and fangs. Snake venom. Snake venom is a complicated mixture of many organic compounds, for example, protocolicins, cardiotoxins, hemorrhagin, neurotoxins and antibactericidum, etc. Various symptoms are shown by the victim of snake bite by different snakes. In the cobra bite, the victim feels pain, weakness and difficult breathing. There is profuse salivation and frequent vomiting. The victim also becomes much lethargic. There is nervous breakdown also. In krait venom, the victim feels pain in abdomen, rest symptoms are like cobra. In the case of viper poison, swelling at the place of biting is very common, also rupture of endothelium, hemorrhage and blood clotting are very common signs.